I'm just gonna. No, actually, checks is good enough to raise. Like, the only possible downsides of raising check downside of raising checks is that I do get that some people might 3-bet jam king jack king queen against it, but I think now with the flat here we see more jams from like sixes and stuff, so should be good enough. I'm in for four bullets, so pray for me. Get two calls here, three calls. Flop is pretty. It's alright. It's alright. There's no ace, king, or queen on the flop, so generally that's good, obviously, but we're four ways, so there's some scary stuff out there. I'm just gonna go with a half pot bet and go for it. That is a good strategy here, I think. Button calls. I think like button can have some sets here, you know. And obviously some flush draws, hopefully not a king queen of diamonds. I think I still just jam the turn here. And as such, just hope he doesn't have threes or deuces or the king queen of diamonds or the king queen of hearts. Queen jack of hearts, you know, you get it. But for this SPR, I think all in is the size to go. Alright, it's not a bad result. Schäfchen gibt es noch trocken. Low. Downside of this spot is that the hands that he's bluffing with have great equity against me. Mostly. Like a king, queen, a queen nine. I will still call one. And see what to do on the river. I feel like he, his sizing wise, it's like a bluff or the 10. I don't really think he's checked that often. The blind is not 1,000, it's like 85. No, it's 150 bucks. That was awful math, dude. What the fuck, Rusty? easy jam and hope that I don't stone bubble this. Please. Oh shit. Nah, he's gonna fold. Yeah. Queens, I jam, and I expect to see a fold. Really hope nobody backs up with something here. It's better than queens, that would be quite unfortunate. Oh, shows jacks there, damn. Oh, it might be in the money here. If king queen holds true. Yep, that's it. GG, finding the money, 2k locked up, two more ladders to break even because I'm in for four bullets. But right now things look pretty decent. I mean, the four of us have a few more chips, but we have these two super short stacks, and then, I mean, these two guys are actually this guy. Yeah. I mean, everybody's kind of short. That was a long bubble. Alright, life is easy. Like, if he opens button here, we're just jamming and pray he doesn't call. Wow, fuck my life. Alright. We have a jam like ace deuce here. Yeah, he's a tough guy who does it. Like, he never has a better hand here, obviously, when he jams, so it's just a flip or a head. I think the payouts, the ladders are not worth it, not to take the spot and play for, like, win. The question is, does he ever jam, like, an ace x like this, or are we just only flipping? And that's where I'm not sure. Like, an a7, just rip it in. I mean, he's gone for some big jams before, so I'm tempted to call here, and I think I will. Good luck. Yeah, this is just me playing for first right now and ignoring the next couple of ladders. But if I win this one, I'm in such a good spot. Come on, hold. Hold. Hold! Yeah, man, let's fucking go. Oof. This is where you, like, ICM is a very interesting concept. And this spot is very interesting. Like, it's kind of bad to call for me. Oof. You must study those ICM so hard. Yeah, he makes, like, some ICM comment, and That's what I think, like, ICM is very complicated, you know. You cannot just, like, put stuff into ICM, so it's not enough. There's lots of future EV in winning this one. And as you see, like, the ladders, like, this will change everything, how I'm able to play for the next, like, there's so much future EV in this one. So now I'm just able to play freely instead of just, you know, kind of trying to get two ladders and then trying to get some more ladders after this. Now I'm the boss and my chance of winning went up tremendously. He's salty, which I understand a little bit. Would have folded 10 out of 10 times. I mean, either you fold there or you don't. It doesn't matter if you fold there 1,000 out of 1,000 times. Either it's a good spot or not. Once again, it just has good. There's advantages to it and downsides to it. Alright. Wait, back to the fine table. Aces versus ace 9, and we're down to 4. That was quick. I'm short now on the 530 bounty. Open this. Big man jams 8 blinds. Gonna call with king queen. He has ace king. Not the best hand, but obviously can't fold for less than 10 bigs with this one. Check. Good old chop with the check. Thank you. Naturally, he just loves me. You know, obviously rigged in my favor because sponsor pro, etc, etc, etc. You know how it is. Slopey gets a nice spot to jam. Alright, this could be a big one. Obviously, ace 10-4 is a good board for me. He can have ace 10 and he can have ace 4 and he can have 4s, but that's about it. I'm gonna start with a half pot bet. Just size up a bit. Might miss out on a bit of value from king, queen, king, jack, queen, jack. That just decides to fold flop now. I think generally I should bet like a 30 a lot. This does not make me happy, but I'm gonna call one. And now I will go broke if he has king, queen, or spades, or pocket fours. These two combinations of ace four suited, two, and then like offsuit combinations of ace ten offsuit as well, so I just can't fold here. Good luck. Wow, what an unreal punt, what in the fucking world? Boom! Whoa! Whoa, 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 not even a spade, just whoa, what? What? That is such an insane jam. I would never expect a jam like that without a spade. Just nothing, just a gut shot for the 9, possibly drawing dead. What in the fucking world was that jam? I mean, it might be really good because I'm just folding everything to it. Holy shit, dude. Alright, we're three-handed. Oh, might be heads up here. I take a chop here. Alright, let's get the check now. The chop is over. When will it end? Calls. Alright, let's do a flip. Good start. Good turn. Come on. Yes, man! Very nice stuff. Guaranteed 11,001. Playing for 18k. Let's win it. Next level ICM. Yeah, I can't expect him to ever bluff there because of ICM. But yeah. Literally gifted. That was an unreal punt. For bullets you're shooting today. Dude, I fire like many bullets in this before the stream usually and then just don't make it to the stream. Spammy, me winning the tournament because I held with ace 10 versus king queen doesn't make it correct. Alright, let's hold for the win. Come on, 10. Ace. Ace for the lulz. No, come on, this is not good. This guy wins a few too many all-ins. This is the third one now. And even a 3-outer. If I don't spontaneously decide to stream it after 3 days of streaming in a row, at that point, I'll probably watch. Yeah, I think I'm just raising it here. I mean, I think he's just c-betting like at 100% almost here, so the raise should be pretty good. Obviously, getting it in with a flush draw for 20 bigs heads up, it's like never bad. Just kind of nice to have some flush draws in my flatting, like calling range. Having a check is not too bad because I think a check is a card that he will bluff a lot. So if I turn top pair, he's going to bluff it a bunch. But then again, like he bets half pot, I raise, and he's going to fold a lot. So this is also a pretty good outcome. All right, let's hope he jams. Come on, let's win it. All in number four against him. Don't do this. All right, we have a flip, sadly. Should be dominating here pretty often. Good start. Faded ace, faded queen. Once more. Nice. There's the trophy. Let's fucking go. That ace turn off call. And then just making things happen. 18,000. That's a good amount of money, guys. feels good. Alright, first day back on the grind. There's the tournament chip. Beautiful stuff right there. Beautiful. Oh, man. That's how you start your session, you know? I'm not even 2 hours into the stream and there's already an 18k score. Let's quickly ask Google how much that is. $18,167 is $2,573. There you go. $2,573. Damn, they dropped hard. So the buy-in was a bit smaller than usual, but I fucking take a 2.5k win. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit the follow button as well. See ya.